Everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Sasha. For those of you who do know me, thank you for tuning back in. I want to go ahead and point out a video of mine that has the most views, and I just want to say thank you to everyone who has been watching that video and who has shared it and who has commented and liked it. That is a video where I talk about when I took my TEAS test, that is the entrance exam into nursing school, and that video got over 1,300 views, and I'm still receiving comments and messages from you guys, and I just want to say thank you so much. That really, really shocked me. But honestly, the reason why I made that video is because getting into nursing school, that was probably the video that I looked for the most, was how to ace the TEAS. How do I get into nursing school? How do I study for the TEAS? That was the video I was searching for the most. And so that's a video that I decided to create for you guys to show you guys how I ended up passing my TEAS. So I just want to say thank you so much for those who are watching that video, for those who have shared it, liked it, and commented. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. And I'm so glad that that video has helped you guys and inspired you.
Al otro día volvemos. Oh, yeah. Tú sabes cómo lo hacemos, baby.
Get into what's in my clinical bag. But a quick update, I am in fundamentals, and so fundamentals is basically going to be kind of the stepping stones of nursing. This is going to be where you go and do your head-to-toe assessment on your first patient. This is where you're going to start really doing hands-on work. So you're going to go to a clinical site, wherever that may be. You're going to have your instructor, you're going to have your team, and you're gonna need to bring things with you. You can't just show up, but you're gonna need to bring things with you. And so today I wanna share with you guys what I have brought to clinicals and how I carry it. Has it been useful for me? Are there other things that you may want to invest in? And that's just what we're gonna go over today. First off, my first day of clinicals was about 2 weeks ago, and we are at a senior living facility, an AL. There also is a memory care unit, and we got sent to the memory care unit on our first day. So that was a little intimidating because I really thought I was gonna be working with the people on the AL side, getting to talk to people, getting to interact and do my head to toe. But on the memory care, it was a little bit harder because these patients, they have Alzheimer's, they have dementia. They're not quite mentally there. Their cognitive level isn't there. So it's a little complicated, it's a little intimidating, but you gotta step into your nursing shoes and really just take what you've learned from class and apply it. Your instructor's there to help you, your team members are there to help you. Hopefully your instructor doesn't just pair you up by yourself. Luckily she paired us up in twos. If I didn't know something, my partner did, and then vice versa. So hopefully that's what they're doing with you. If not, honestly, I would just ask your instructor as many questions as possible. That's what they're there for. So don't be intimidated like I was, but it can be intimidating, especially if you have no medical background, no experience working in a medical facility. It can be very intimidating. So before the first day of clinicals, I packed my bag. And so I've been preparing for clinicals for a couple weeks now. I've been ordering things off Amazon, making sure that when I get to clinical, I'm comfortable, I have what I need, and that I'm not scrambling around the night before trying to pack my bag. So over break, for Christmas break actually, I was gifted with my Vera Bradley tote. So I got this at the outlet mall. It was my Christmas gift for my dad's wife, but we went together and I picked out what I wanted. So this is a Vera Bradley tote. I've never bought from Vera Bradley before. So this is my first Vera Bradley item. And this is a tote. I don't know the size, I don't know the name. It's probably one of the larger totes that she has. And this is from the outlet mall. So I live in Tampa. We have a Tampa Premium Outlet Mall. This was already 50% off with an extra 30. And because I work at the hospital, I got an extra 10. So actually this tote was like, base price was $140 something. So I think we got this after all the discounts. I think we got it for around, I want to say like 45, maybe something like that. So we got the tote and the inside pattern's really cute. I don't know if you guys can see, like the inside patterns, like some flowers and stuff. Sorry, my tote's really heavy. So I got the tote And I love it. I love it. It's durable. It holds everything. And I've gotten a lot of compliments on this. Actually, one of the nurses on my unit has the same exact tote, same color and everything, and she loves it. So I was actually kind of nervous buying this tote because I was like, I don't know if it's going to hold all my things. And it's actually, even with all of my things in it, it's very spacious. So this tote's excellent. It carries everything and it's perfect. So I don't want to just recommend a tote because carrying around things on one shoulder can be very overbearing. Some people like the backpack. The Vera Bradley store had the backpacks. You guys have seen my backpack that I carry to school. I still use that, but I found the tote to just be a lot easier than the backpack. I do still use my backpack, but it's got all those zippers and compartments, and it just started getting a little bit frustrating for me. I'm very simple and to the point. I like to just go in and grab what I need. With the tote, inside I've got, obviously, my laptop. This is a MacBook. So this is what I do my schoolwork and my videos on. I did not carry it with me to clinicals on day one. I didn't really need it, but I do still carry it with me in my tote to class when I bring it. It's just to show you guys how big this tote is, that it can still fit my laptop. So inside that, I got my laptop, and I've also got my laptop charger, of course, because laptops don't last all day. So my charger. Next, I have obviously my planner. I bring this with me everywhere I go. It does not matter if I'm at school, at clinical, at work, or just my day off. I have to have my planner, you guys. Like, I can't. I can't live without this thing. Everything that I need to know is in here. And if someone calls me and asks me, like, when is my next day off, I'm not gonna know if I don't have this. So I always carry it with me, and that's kept in here. And I move it from different purses to different bags. So I always have to make sure I have my planners. Also, I have a pens and pencils, like, I don't know what you guys call this, bag or something. It's not even a real, like, pencil bag. It's actually a makeup bag that I got from Target. I just couldn't find one that was cute to hold pencils. Maybe you can find one on Amazon, but I got this from Target, and it's got all my pens and pencils in here, like every single color, highlighters, markers, everything. So it holds enough, and I keep that in my bag, and I bring this with me everywhere I go as well, even to clinical, because during clinical you're going to be filling out tons of paperwork, and you're going to need different colors, different highlighters, different markers, because the way you fill out this paperwork is gonna be what you're studying for, or if your professor's like mine, we have a assignment due every week, so. Next I have, and this is cute, I got this off Amazon. This is a case for my stethoscope, pen light, etc. So you unzip this like so, and on the first compartment I have my shears. I've got two. I've got one that I got from, I don't know, like the scrub store. I'm not really crazy about these ones. And then I got one that my manager gave me at work for Christmas. And these are actually really good. So I've got a small one, a big one. And then I've got my pen light. I've ordered some more off Amazon because my daughter was playing around with mine and she broke it. It had like a little clip that you could clip to your jacket or scrub pocket, and that's lost or broke or whatever. So I had to order a couple more. You do use these. So I would honestly order maybe about two or three. So in case you lose them, unless you leave it at clinical and you forget it, or someone borrows it, or your child breaks it, etc. It's always good to have a couple of these. I ordered this one off Amazon. And it only came with one. So I need another one, and I ordered some more. So I'm waiting on those. And, you know, all your pen lights and stuff can go in here. And then you flip this compartment over, and then it's where you hold your stethoscope. I never had a case before until I started watching some YouTube videos, and a lot of girls had cases for their stethoscopes. And I was like, you know what? It's an expensive piece of equipment, and you want to take care of it. It's not something you just want to throw around and forget about. Honestly, stethoscopes, they range from, you can get a really, really, really cheap one for like 12, 15 bucks. It's not going to work as great as some of the higher ones do. This one that I have, and I didn't buy a Littmann. I did not buy a Littmann. I'm going to buy a Littmann when I'm done with school. You don't need a Littmann for school. You don't. Everything that you do in school is going to be so basic that you just don't need a Littmann. I got this one. It's an ADC stethoscope. It's rose gold and black. I got this from the scrub store, and this still was expensive. It was $75, and I think that was with a discount. Some of the Lipmans run from $120 and up. The one that I want is about $250. So that's going to be the one I'm going to buy when I am done with school. But this stethoscope works. I got it from the scrub store, like I said, $75. It's an ADC, and honestly, I read some of the reviews with the ADC. It's very similar to Lipman. It looks like a Lipman, you know, kind of similar to Lipman, but, you know, Lipman is a Lipman. We all want it. So hopefully that's an instrument that if you have right now during nursing school, good for you. But if you can't afford it, do not stress yourself to buy a Lipman. You don't need it. Honestly, some of the cheaper ones, like the $20 ones that you can get from Walgreens, those are gonna work. You just need a stethoscope. That's it. I got this one. I like the way it works, but I am gonna have a Lipman when I graduate. So that's that. This is my stethoscope, and just, you guys, please take care of your instrument. Like I said, don't just throw it around. Don't just leave it hanging. Don't let your kids play with it. My daughter has played with mine, and thankfully it's not broken, but if it were to break, then I'd have to buy a new one, and then I'd be upset. So this is a good investment. I got this off Amazon for, I think, $12. If I'm not mistaken, but I'll link it below. And they come in all different colors, different, I guess, brands or people who sell it on Amazon. But I got the pink one because pink is my favorite color. I have my blood pressure cuff. So a lot of the sites that you may be going to for fundamentals are going to be places like rehabs, ALF, SNFs, assisted living. You may go to the hospital. I know some teams at my school have gone to one of the hospitals here, but for me, I'm at an AL, and so there's not a lot of equipment in these facilities. So you might want to just bring your own. And I know a lot of the nurses at these facilities, they bring their own equipment. So, cause you know, these facilities, they don't provide you with it like the hospitals do. So it's best to just bring everything that you need. And if they have it there, great. If they don't, then you're in luck because you brought your own stuff. So this blood pressure cuff I got off of Amazon as well. I actually have two because, I don't know, something got mistaken with Amazon and they brought me two. So I have two. And I want to tell you guys I'm not in love with this one. Maybe I'm just used to the ones at the hospital, but this one's, it's all right. It's all right. I'm not too crazy about it, but it does the job. So it came with the cuff. And it came with the sphygmometer. It came with everything. So I'm not in love with it. I think because of this metal like bracket piece that I just don't like. I just don't like that. It gets really like tangled and everything. And it's kind of awkward when you're putting it on the patient to have to untangle it and make sure it's facing the right way. There are better cuffs. So this one off Amazon, I think it was like $10. So it's not one of the better ones. This was honestly like a last minute I need, and I just bought it off Amazon. It comes with its own little bag, which is great because it's small and compact and it can fit in my bag. By the way, Amazon has Student Prime for those of you who need Prime like I do. Amazon has Student Prime. I think it's $69.99 for the whole entire year. When you sign up, it will renew automatically on the day that you signed up the next year. So just a reminder of that, but it's $69.99 for the Student Prime. All you need is your student email. You go ahead and you sign up and there you go. All right. So next I got off Amazon, I got this clipboard. It's a nursing clipboard. So it's just like a regular clipboard. On the back, it's got, the RN charts and everything on here, like blood pressure, it's got lab values, etc. And then you open it like this and all your paperwork is on the inside, which is great for HIPAA reasons. So HIPAA, you don't want to just leave things hanging around, especially at the facilities. Even if you're on a memory care, like you're gonna be like, oh, these patients don't know, but you just never wanna leave patient information lying around. You'd never want to get up and walk away with your paperwork there. Even if it's just schoolwork, you're still writing about the patient that you're seeing for the day. So this is excellent, honestly, because you could just put your paperwork in here, clip it like that. There, nothing is left, nothing is visual. For anyone who walks by, they can't see what you have written. But I will say, This was a hassle carrying around on the first day of clinical. I did not want to carry this around all day. I carried it when I first did my head-to-toe assessment. It was hard to hold. I just felt really awkward with this. And I love the compartment that it had, but it just was not, it wasn't ideal for my day that I was having. So a lot of my team members had, and I just ordered it off Amazon, they had one of these. It's the same thing, but it's just a metal clipboard that folds like that. So you could put your paperwork in here, write on it, fold it up when you're done, and it fits in your scrub pocket. Like, it's amazing. It fits in your scrub pocket. So this I got off Amazon. Honestly, the cheapest I could find it was $21.99. So this was $21.99, and it comes with different kinds of stickers. It comes with the RN stickers, where it's like lab values, blood pressure. You've got the Perla right here, and then it comes with I guess a med student kind of stickers. You do have to put the stickers on yourself, and I'm upset because I've already messed up, but whatever, I'm not gonna stress it. So this is actually I feel is gonna be more convenient. I have clinical next week, so I'm gonna see how this works out for me, but it seemed to work out for everyone else on my team, so I'm so glad that I got this, because this was kind of a hassle, but I'm still gonna keep this because I like how you could just lock everything away and leave it. But this is definitely gonna be my go-to for clinical days. And honestly, a lot of the nurses in the hospital, they have this too. Lastly, what I carry in my clinical bag is a lunchbox. This is my Vera Bradley lunchbox. It's not that big. They do have bigger lunchboxes, but I bought this one just because on clinical days, I just bring snacks, to be honest. We get an hour lunch. I'm just gonna go to lunch. There's a Publix across the street, and that's what I'll probably end up eating. But for snacks, because we have 12-hour days. So a lot of people for clinicals, every school's different, every instructor's different, every dean is different. So for our program, our dean, they just changed it to 12-hour days. I know last quarter they were doing, I think they broke it up. So some teams did 6-1, and the other teams did 1-6. So this quarter, they're breaking it up to 12-hour days, but every other week. So last quarter, they had to do every week. This quarter, we only do every other week. So I did clinical last Monday. Today, I'm off. Next Monday, I'll go, and vice versa. Snacks is what you need. You will get breaks. We get 2:15 and then like an hour lunch. And honestly, we're not even out on the floor all day. We keep coming back to the conference room to debrief. So you can't have drinks and snacks out on the floor, but in the conference room or wherever you gather, you can keep your things in there behind a locked door. And I'd suggest to just bring snacks, bring water, bring juices, whatever it is that you need to keep yourself energized and hydrated. Inside the Vera Bradley bag, isn't it cute? It's got so many compartments and things on the side. I just love it. I absolutely love it. All right, y'all. So that's pretty much it. That's what's in my clinical bag for now. If anything changes, I will let you know. But that's really all you need, because everything else is whatever printouts and handouts your instructor wants you to start filling out, like head to toe or the ISBAR and things like that. So it's best to just keep all of your paperwork together in one of the clipboards that I've shown you guys. And honestly, that's about it. Just go to clinical, be confident. That's honestly my number one tip, is just be confident. I know some of you have never ever had any type of medical experience, and it can be difficult, but be confident. And if you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. Like, your instructor, she or he is there to help. They understand. Alongside that, I know a lot of people are nervous because when they go to clinicals, they're afraid if the nurses there are gonna be treating you bad or not really helping you. That hasn't been the case so far on my end. And a lot of the nursing students that come to my job, now where I work, we don't even treat them like that. So, and if they do treat you like that, please do not hesitate to tell your instructor. Your instructor obviously has some sort of relationship with maybe the nurse manager on that floor, and they will not hesitate to mention that at all to them. So if anyone's going to treat you like you're a bother, or they're not showing you things, or they're just kind of never minding you while you're there, don't hesitate to tell somebody and maybe be reassigned to a different nurse. But luckily that has not been the case on my end. Everyone's been very nice. The CNAs, the nurses, the therapy people that come in, everyone's been very, very nice and very welcoming. I have not felt like I've been a bother. So, and that's excellent. And another thing, they need the help. So when nursing students come on my unit where I work, we need the help. The CNAs are ecstatic. So it's extra hands. And, you know, hospitals are already understaffed as it is. And so when we have students coming in who are willing to do bed changes and bed baths and bring drinks and food, that's amazing. That's extra help. So just know you're there, you're needed, and nobody's going to treat you like you're a bother. Just don't feel like that. And be confident. You know, you're a nursing student. Everyone has been in your shoes. Like, nobody has never been in nursing school and never felt like they've messed up, or, you know, that they didn't know something. So everyone's been in your shoes. What you know, others might, and vice versa. So we're all here to help each other. That's what these videos are for. And I'm so excited that you're here and that you're watching these videos. All right, guys, and that's it. Thank you so much for watching. And if you haven't already, please like and subscribe. I will see you guys next time. All right, bye-bye.